Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here, and thanks for tuning in. Most of us have been guilty of rushing an aquarium setup at some point or another, and as Murphy's Law would have it, this almost always ends up in complications. Whether you add too many fish all at once, you fail to properly cure your live rock, or just not wait long enough before adding animals, all of this can cause some serious problems in your tank. In this Marine Depot video, we're going to show you guys how to properly cycle your reef aquarium and provide some insight into why this is so crucial to the success of your tank. The most traditional way of cycling a tank is to use live rock, add some sand, and basically just wait. Live rock is couriered from the ocean and is teeming with beneficial bacteria. En route to your home, the rock spends several days out of water, and during this time, a significant portion of beneficial bacteria and other organisms will die. When added to your tank, the remaining living bacteria will seed the aquarium with a variety of different bacteria strains, and the dead matter will break down and release harmful ammonia and nitrate into your aquarium water. When using fresh live rock, it is best to remove any sponges and other large, obviously dead organisms. Then give the rock a quick rinse in a bucket of salt water to rid the rock of any additional decaying matter. After cleaning the rock, you'll simply place it in your tank. The good nitrifying bacteria will take roughly 30 to 45 days to establish in the aquarium, all the while being fed continually by the decaying matter from the live rock. During this time, the nitrogen cycle is being established, and you should test the water 2 to 3 times per week. You should first notice a rise in the ammonia level, then a rise in the nitrite levels. Once both the ammonia and nitrite have risen and start falling back down toward zero, you'll notice that the nitrates start to accumulate and become present in your water tests. Usually after about 4 to 6 weeks of cycling, you will notice the ammonia and nitrite levels have fallen back down to zero, and nitrates will be obviously present in the water. At this time, your tank is properly cycled, and you can perform a 25 to 30% water change before starting to add animals. Bacteria supplements like the Microbacter 7 and C-Chem Stability are a great way to help speed up the cycle process and ensure a diverse population of bacteria in your tank. It's also a good idea to use them on a weekly basis after your cycle is complete to ensure a healthy and diverse population of bacteria is maintained in your aquarium. Dry rock, such as the Aquamax Eco Rock and the Carib Sea Life Rock, is becoming very popular for saltwater aquariums. It is great because it keeps unwanted hitchhikers out of your aquarium, it has minimal environmental impact, and is generally much less expensive when compared to live rock. Now, because dry rock is free of bacteria and dead organic matter, a slightly different approach is required to properly cycle the tank. The best option is to use a bacteria supplement to add bacteria strains into your aquarium. You'll then also need to provide the aquarium with some organics to support the growing bacteria population. This is accomplished by phantom feeding, which basically means you add a small amount of fish food to the aquarium on a regular basis to support the bacteria. It is not uncommon for cycling with dry rock to take a little longer, but does have some great benefits. As with the traditional method of cycling with live rock, you'll still need to test the water regularly to monitor the cycling process. And once the nitrates are present and ammonia and nitrite have dropped down to zero, it is safe to start adding animals into the aquarium. The best advice that I can give a new hobbyist starting their first aquarium is that patience is the key for success in this hobby. Allow nature to run its course and go slowly. All too often, we hear about our customers adding too many fish at one time or adding fish too quickly to their aquariums, resulting in a total loss. A good general rule to follow when stocking a new tank is 1 fish per week. So if you're just starting out in this hobby, remember that adding fish and other animals to your aquarium before it is properly cycled can cause some easily avoidable deaths. This is unfair to the animals, and not to mention a waste of your hard-earned dollars. For all you seasoned hobbyists, we know you've been told time and time again, and only hope that you'll lead by example for the generations of hobbyists to come. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.